Elon Musk has approached brain chip implant developer Synchron Inc. about a possible investment, according to four people familiar with the matter, as his own company Neuralink tries to catch up in the race to connect the human brain directly to machines. According to the sources, Musk reached out to Synchron's founder and CEO, Thomas Oxley, recently to discuss a potential deal. It is unclear whether any transaction would involve a collaboration or tie-up between Synchron and Neuralink. Welcome to First Class Tech, and in this video, we'll take a look at everything you need to know about the Synchron chip and its latest updates. According to the sources, Synchron, based in the New York City borough of Brooklyn, is ahead of Neuralink in the process of obtaining regulatory clearance for its devices. It has not decided whether to accept an investment, and no deal is certain, according to the sources. According to four current and former Neuralink employees, Musk expressed frustration with the company's slow progress. Two of the sources added that when Musk reached out to Oxley, he did not convey his frustration. It's unclear where Neuralink stands in its application to the United States Food and Drug Administration to begin human trials. Musk stated in a public presentation in 2019 that Neuralink, which he launched in 2016, hoped to obtain regulatory approval by the end of 2020. He then stated that he hoped to begin human trials this year at a Wall Street Journal conference in late 2021. Synchron, which was founded in 2016, has developed a brain implant that, unlike Neuralink's product, does not require cutting into the skull to install. Its goal is to enable paralyzed patients to operate digital devices solely with their minds. Synchron reached a significant milestone last month when it implanted its device for the first time in a patient in the United States. It received FDA approval for human trials in 2021 and has completed four studies in Australia. According to market research firm PitchBook, Synchron has approximately 60 employees and has raised approximately $65 million from investors. Neuralink is the larger company, with 300 employees spread across San Francisco and Austin, Texas. According to PitchBook, it has so far raised $363 million from investors. Only two of the company's eight founders have remained, Musk and implant engineer Dongjin DJ Seo, who holds a leadership position. Max Hodak, who retired as president of Neuralink last year, is now an investor in Synchron. Musk has previously approached Neuralink's competitors. According to three people familiar with the situation, he held talks with the brain technology company Paradromics Incorporated in 2020. Musk later dropped out of those talks, according to two of these sources. By the way, if you're watching us for the first time, make sure to hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so you can enjoy our future videos while getting updated. Getting back to the topic. The first US clinical trial of a human brain implant that restores communication ability to severely paralyzed people has begun, potentially turning science fiction into reality. In the United States, Synchron announced the first human BCI implant. This procedure is a significant technological milestone for scalable BCI devices, and it is the first to take place in the United States using an endovascular BCI approach, which does not require invasive open brain surgery. The implantation procedure went extremely well, and the patient was able to leave the hospital 48 hours later. The procedure was carried out at Mount Sinai, West in New York, under the supervision of clinical investigator Sharam Majidi, MD, assistant professor of neurosurgery, neurology, and radiology at Mount Sinai's Icahn School of Medicine. The procedure was carried out using a minimally invasive endovascular approach in the angiography suite. Mount Sinai's Department of Rehabilitation and Human Performance assisted in the procedure's coordination. The procedure marks the first patient implant in the United States in Synchron's COMMAND trial, which is being conducted under the FDA's first investigational device exemption granted to a company evaluating a permanently implanted BCI. The NIH Neural Interfaces Program is funding the trial in the United States. The COMMAND study will look at the safety and efficacy of the company's motor BCI technology platform, which includes a Stentron, in patients with severe paralysis, with the goal of allowing the patient to control digital devices hands-free. The study's findings include the use of brain data to control digital devices and improve functional independence. This is an incredibly exciting milestone for the field because of its implication and enormous potential, said Sharam Majidi, MD, the neurointerventional surgeon who performed the procedure and an assistant professor of neurosurgery, neurology, and radiology at Mount Sinai. The first in-human implant of an endovascular BCI in the United States is a significant clinical milestone that opens up new possibilities for paralysis patients, said Tom Oxley. Our technology is for the millions of people who have lost the ability to control digital devices with their hands. We're thrilled to bring a scalable BCI solution to market, one that has the potential to change so many people's lives. In a minimally invasive endovascular procedure, the stentrode is implanted within the motor cortex of the brain via the jugular vein. It detects and wirelessly transmits motor intent using a proprietary digital language once implanted, allowing severely paralyzed patients to control personal devices with hands-free point and click. The trial will look at how commonplace tasks like texting, emailing, online shopping, and accessing telehealth services affect people's ability to live independently. According to the company, its device will allow patients to wirelessly control external devices by thinking about moving their limbs, which can help with everything from texting and emailing to online shopping and telemedicine. The goal of Synchron is to achieve whole brain data transfer, Oxley continued. Our first target is the motor cortex for the treatment of paralysis, which represents a large unmet need for millions of people worldwide and a $20 billion market opportunity. The device is conveyed to the brain via blood vessels in a 2-hour minimally invasive procedure similar to the placement of stents in the heart, according to Synchron. The procedure, according to the company, can be performed in widely available angiography suites, and there are no wires coming out of the body after the device is implanted. In addition, Synchron claims that no robotic assistance is required for its procedure, in contrast to competitor Neuralink, which previously unveiled a robot designed to implant its chips. Synchron is currently conducting a separate clinical trial outside of the United States, with 4 patients in Australia already receiving the implant. Last year, the company published a study in which the first 2 patients were able to control their devices to text and type through direct thought. Synchron received breakthrough device designation from the FDA in August 2020. Synchron will continue to enroll patients in its COMMAND trial, which is the industry's first FDA-approved clinical trial for a permanently implanted BCI in the United States. Long-term safety results from Synchron's SWITCH trial in Australia have shown that this technology is safe in 4 patients for up to 12 months. The Stentrode, Synchron's flagship technology, is an endovascular brain implant that allows patients to wirelessly control digital devices through thought and improve functional independence. A motor neuroprosthesis, or motor BCI, Synchron's foundational technology, is implanted via the jugular vein using neurointerventional techniques commonly used to treat stroke, and does not require drilling into the skull or open brain surgery. The system is intended for patients who are paralyzed as a result of a variety of conditions. It is intended to be user-friendly and dependable enough for patients to use on their own. Neuralink made headlines in April when it released a video of its chip in action in a monkey. The video showed a macaque named Pager 6 weeks after receiving the implant in its brain playing video games with its mind. Elon tweeted at the time that the company's first device would enable someone with paralysis to use a smartphone with their mind faster than someone using thumbs. Oxley aspires to 1 million implants per year, which is the number of stents and cardiac pacemakers implanted each year. He estimates that goal is 15 to 20 years away, and he enjoys the debate surrounding technology, even if it irritates him. What I want the rest of the world to understand is that this technology will benefit people, he says. There appears to be a theme here about the potential negative aspects of this technology or where it might go. But the reality is that people need this technology now. And with that being said, it's time to end our video. What are your views about the Synchron chip and its future? Let us know in the comments. Like this video and make sure to subscribe to the channel for more amazing videos like this. We'll see you in the next video.